This is now the next version of the node editor in FreeCAD on PyFlow. And a short demonstration, I generate a scene. In this case, I have here created some nodes and I've connected them. Let's start with this node. The toy is playing an object which creates a box. So I can start it, I can click on it, and sometimes I have some trouble with my mouse. I think it's not okay. If I now run execute, then a box is created. We see it here, okay. And the next thing is when I run execute again, nothing happens. So I have here a flag randomize, and if I set the randomize flag, then execute means a new object with some randomized coordinates is created. This way. The same I have here, this toy works in the same manner, and in the whole scene I have here a timer, and the timer creates over the sequence object, I will use it later, this toy, and this toy is connected to a boolean here, and here I can make a fusion. Let's look at this object. We see in this object we have a mode fuse, and it will create the fusion of these two toys. So I start the timer. I always have some problem with clicking this object. Maybe my mouse is too old to work with my computer and I have to buy a new one. I have updated the driver, or still the problem occurs. Okay, I run the timer and I say I use about 1 second. So, and we see there is nothing. We have here three objects, my toy, boolean, and my toy, the second one. And I will configure them, so I say my toy should be placed as wireframe, and I will use line color, say blue. And the other toys should be displayed in wireframe 2 with line color, say green. Okay, and then we have here the boolean, and we say this one should be a red shape with transparency 30, so we can look inside later. We have this, and at the moment we see nothing happens. So let's go back to the scene, and this toy here is still not randomized. That means it's always the same. So what can I do? I can go to this toy and I can so say execute, and in this case diffusion changed. But better for animation is that I change the animated toy. This this toy is animated from my time over my sequence to the toy. And now I set here the flag randomize. And now we see what happens. The figure changes. And the next thing what I do is I go to boolean and always the problem with the mouse click. And here I have the mode. The mode is an enumeration pin, so I can select between a list of values, and the most interesting in this case is cut. So when I press cut, now we see the impact of cut. Here we see the difference of the two cubes. And at the moment only toy 1 changes the size. Toy 1 is the blue box. When I want to change the toy 2, I have to use this node my sequence. It gets triggered by the timer, and the logic of Pyflow is that I have to connect the out pin 2 with the toy 2. So in this case now both boxes toy and toy 2 change their shape, and we always see the result here in the boolean. So I hope I can click it. Okay, that works. And we also want to see at the end we can mode, we have demonstrated fuse, cut, and also we can use common. And this is the result of a dynamic common. So how can I create these toys? The simplest case is I go here to the scene, I use a tab key, and I write here toy, and I see there's only one node, FreeCAD toy, and when I drag it here, I get such a FreeCAD toy object. Oh, I have dragged it on this curve, so it is inserted into this line. That means that the trigger from my sequence now flows through FreeCAD toy and from here to the other toy and so on. It's a side effect. Very interesting features of the Pyflow application. That's all for today.